What's going on, everyone? Strider's back with another slice of ELO Heaven. This time we are stalking Quantic High. Always been a really, really good player, but don't get to see him often enough. Nom Nom Lemon is also fantastic. Balls is really good. Let's see. I haven't actually seen any of the pros recently. A lot of the pros, I don't exactly know what the pros have been doing. I'm assuming they're all in MLG Dallas area. Ish, they're probably still on vacation, just kind of hanging out, getting ready. I mean, most of the pros, I was trying to get some of the EU people on today because Wicked and Froggen and Crepo, basically most of the EG guys were streaming today. I just didn't get a chance to because I had a meeting after work, so very disappointing, but I will try to get that for you guys tomorrow. I think tomorrow may be okay. But we'll see what happens. Make sure to, of course, request any champions or players that you want to see in the comment section below, or just send me a private message with that information. It really does help. I mean, if you guys want to see something in particular, let me know so that I can get it for you guys. If you want to see it, then I can get it. But this is going to be an actual ranked 5s game. So we have not seen a ranked 5s in quite some time. So I'm very excited. Very excited. Although it doesn't look as if the stats program is currently working with the ranked 5s game, which is kind of depressing. I'll have to see what's going on with that, because the last game I had a weird error too. We'll see what happens. I'm assuming Zed will go mid, because a lot of times lately when I have seen Zed, he has gone mid. Which of course is always interesting, but I don't understand the allure towards Zed quite yet. Oh, we do have a nice little bit of engage. We do not have any. Oh, is Cocoon gonna come out? No. Trying to dodge the Cocoon. The auto attacks and the ignite is gonna go down, and that is gonna be Orianna for the first blood. Wham, bibbity bam. Get rocked. And that was actually really, really funny that he kind of stood off to the side a little bit to try to dodge the potential Cocoon, but she actually had Venomous Bite and not Cocoon, which is kind of funny. Because you almost always see Cocoon first level. It's very rare that you do not see that. Very, very rare. So I'm surprised that she ended up going with, the neurotoxin and everything. But it did do a lot of damage, and that's really what you need when it comes to a level 1 fight, especially when you had everything covered. There's no way she was going to flash over the wall. Did what she could, try to flash towards the tower, but not going to be enough. Blue team, in the meantime, camping out quite a bit. This could be bad. Draven does do quite a significant amount of damage, possibly just trying to, do it in front load damage. Wow, nice. Glitterlance slowing down all three members of that red team, getting them... I'm not really low per se. Ooh, nice. Is he gonna be able to pop that passive? I think that's what they're really trying to do. No, he's gonna be forced to smite it. Gonna flash, gets the fling onto Lululu. Is gonna have to flash, but oh man, the bear is on a rampage. Chosen Storm, yes, his passive does get procced finally, and this is really dangerous now at this point. Lulu is going really close to dying. She does not have flash anymore, and that is gonna be a kill. Ooh, Glitterlance once again just barely getting it. One more auto attack and that would have been a headshot and easily a kill. But unfortunately, it did not happen that way. This is going to put Draven and Lulu a little bit further behind, although there is not going to be a whole lot that the other team can do, and a whole nice waste of the flash. Not really a waste of the flash, but nice use of the flash coming out from Zed, but nice way of forcing out the flash. So it's a really good Cocoon, kind of threaded the needle between the minions. Not a very easy skill shot to land, of course, because it will hit the first target it goes to. It's one of the only real skill shot stuns. Most of them are kind of targetable or like an area of effect type of thing, but it's like that, and bandage toss are pretty rough to land. Oh, Cocoon is a little bit more detrimental, of course, but that's besides the point. Zed is getting quite outfarmed here. I don't know how well he can actually farm at the tower. And oh, this could be really bad. Will she get it? And oh my gosh, one auto attack, boom, hitting it off. But this is not good. She is running away. I don't know if she'll be able to get away from the rumble. Rumble is so nice. Repel, actually repelling two. Oh, that was beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Boom. Wow, that actually didn't explode. It's away later. Nice cocoon following it up. And wow, she gets away from that. Nice repel to the golems once again. And geez, that was just absolutely amazing. Great escape. Crazy tower dive to the second tower at 4 minutes. Definitely not something you see very frequently. But we have a lot of damage coming in. A hook now going down. Is he going to fall? The lancer coming out, providing him a little bit of health, but not enough of a shield. And wow, Draven doing so much damage. Another Glitter Lance could help, but is it going to be enough? No, speeds are up. Tries to take a tower shot for it, but not going to be enough to kill her. One more auto attack from Draven, I think that would have easily had it. And since Lulu was tanking that tower, I think they could have done it. But he didn't have Flash, and he probably didn't want to risk it anyway. Caitlyn still had Barrier, so it was very possible that she was baiting something out pretty hardcore. It was a pretty rough barrier, though. She knew that they didn't have Flash, neither of them did. So I don't think she was really all that worried. Wow, Zed taking quite a bit of damage, almost going down completely. He's gonna recall from that. Oh, the bear coming in, the bear coming in. She's not quite level 6. Nidalee's gonna get flung to the back, gets ignited, and that is going to be a very dead Nidalee. While Zed in mid goes down once again to the combination of Orianna and Elise. Never a good tower shot to take. Really don't see Elise in the jungle too frequently, but when she does, she tends to have quite an impact sometimes, especially this game. But also at the same time, Volibear's doing a great job actually picking up 2 kills for himself. He has all the kills on his team. And that is very, very important. It's both good and bad to have kills as a jungler. It's great for you because you don't necessarily have to lane tax as hard as well, but it also kind of sucks because you're not really snowballing the lanes. You're just making every other lane just more scared of your ganks, which kind of makes them play more cautious or just buy a ward. Since he doesn't have any real gap closer besides speed up. Ooh, we could have another repel going down. Nice job by Zed getting away from it, but this could be a really bad situation. Ooh, he's able to speed out of the way, and Zed not. Oh, is he going to be able to get away from this? That's the question. He's so much faster. Yeah, he may be able. He's going to be able to execute himself. Elise did not recall, unfortunately. He's just gonna farm kind of at this tower, and bam, gets executed. Gonna be a good enough job. Unfortunately, Orianna wasn't quite able to hit with that command attack. But that would have been awesome. Nice level 6 coming out from Nidalee. Nidalee's doing an insane amount of damage. The Flash Equalizer coming out, but is she gonna get the pounce on the auto attack? Yes, she will. Bam, bam, bam. Rumble goes down once again, also down by about 20 CS at this point. Not good for Rumble. Rumble really needed that kill that Volibear got on the Nidalee up top to help him out, but unfortunately that just did not happen in her favor. And that's never a good thing. So now top lane is just a little bit further behind, and now that Nidalee is level 6, you can't gank her nearly as easily as you could pre-level 6. When she hits level 6, she becomes a freaking monster of mobility. A lot like Gragas. And wow, a beautiful job getting Draven in there. But holy cow, the spinning axe is doing a ridiculous amount of work. Elise gets out of there just barely. But Draven and Lulu are super low. But wow, the hook followed by the flay. That was just beautiful. Zed going real hard in. Orianna grabs him back in directly into the cocoon, and this could be a ridiculous amount of damage, but Volibear is in the mix. Repel coming out. Oh yeah, she gets the kill just barely. Orianna now coming up from the back.
another cocoon coming out, and that is a ton of damage once again. The passive procs, Death Sentence actually lands on one of the spiders, very unfortunate. And bam, one more auto attack is going to be able to pick it up. Thresh coming from behind. Oh, misses the cocoon that time. Oh, Caitlyn. Oh! Oh! They're not enjoying this at all. Ooh, Death Sentence not going through. That could have been really bad. Wow, the blue team's getting away with murder here. Literally, they're just getting away with everything, and it's kind of depressing to see, but it's also pretty awesome at the same time. Blue team recalling, and the kill count is 9-2, one tower in favor of the blue team, and 0 to the red team. At top lane, Nidalee's up by about 30 CS as well as 2 kills. But down an assist, not really a big deal. Assists don't give that much gold. Compared to kills, anyway. Elise is up by only 3 CS. Tied in kills, but up by 4 assists. She's definitely showing quite a bit of lane presence here throughout the entire map. And that's really going to be beneficial. Orianna is up by about 10 CS herself. And also up by 3 kills and 2 assists. Doing a lot of work. Go just all over the map. Doing all that she can to try to kill everybody and make sure that nobody's safe. Nidalee, on the other hand, trying to do, oh my gosh, overheat for Mumble. That could be really dangerous for him. Is he going to be able to get anything crazy out if he has the equalizer? Able to get the double tasers. Not that much, though. Red team pinged out Volibear, trying to go against the Zed. And oh man, if she gets any closer, that could be dangerous. Ooh, nice ultimate. Gonna get slowed down. Oh no, she grabs him kind of into her, but they were both slowed. Elise now come back. Is she gonna be able to get anything? Don't think so, no. They may apply just a ridiculous amount of pressure here. That could be another free tower. Oh, the cocoon coming out. They burst her down almost instantly. Even with his passive, wasn't able to do anything with that lantern. And while the flank coming out, trying to do something. Mox now going down. But ooh, Lay keeps Elise out of all forms of danger. Death Sentence now going down. Not a good situation for her to be in the flank. Taking a tower shot. And this is definitely not good. Those minions are doing so much damage. And oh no, the minions do so much damage. Caitlyn ends up going down 1v1 against the Darius. Or sorry, the Draven. Red team's turret has been destroyed. Draven's just one of those AD carries you do not go 1v1 against. He does a ridiculous amount of damage, and now the blue team takes another tower as it looks like they're gonna go directly for the dragon. Wow, that dragon is just going down super fast, so be able to smite it down.
Blue team has slain the dragon.
Ooh, Rumble gets in a really bad situation once again. Every time he overheats, Nidalee just abuses that mechanic. Is she going to get a spear off? That is the question. She is going a little bit in the AP area. Elise gets killed on Volibear. Volibear takes out the Orianna. Oh, Elise could get a nice cocoon whenever it comes off cooldown. Oh, beautiful job at the cocoon. And the spiders should be able to take him down. Yes, they do.
Rampage.
Great job. And that is going to be a rampage for Elise. 4-0-6. Oh, that is going to be great. Volibear was able to get down the killing spree of Orianna, though. She was 5-0-3, and now she's 5-1-3. Not gonna be good. Volibear, once again, still the only member on the red team with kills, which is not gonna be good for them. They really need to make sure that they kind of distribute it to the people that need the kills. Zed right now not doing too great, and he could use a kill or two for just the bonus gold. But right now, Volibear, he's doing what he can. He gets the lock of the Iron Solari, which gets him a little bit more tanky, his entire team, as long as he's around him. I just don't know how well it's going to be. Nice stand-aside landing. Are they going to get a cocoon? Death Sentence now going down. This could be really dangerous. Repel now coming out. Probably going to cancel it and just go straight down, but it provides a lot of terror because you know a spider's going to drop from the ceiling, but you don't know where. It's either on top of you or away from you. It's better just to run away just in case, because spiders are terrifying. Especially the poison ones that throw cocoons and can't move for a couple seconds. Have you, like, freaking toxins and sounds terrible. Diddly going real hard in the paint, takes a couple tower shots. Is she gonna go down? Oh, the ignite almost picks her off. Barely survives. And oh my gosh, the whirling death doesn't quite land, but oh, this is not good. Nidalee is in a really bad position. She pounces to the tower. Oh man, she's getting nice jukes. And that was just a really bad decision. I think she'll get caught up to... No, not quite. Wow, nice job. Elise coming in. Oh, just barely misses the cocoon. Spear going down. And this is not going to be good for him. Bulletbear goes down almost instantly. It's not that tanky. He's not able to take it down. The most fed person on their team. Well, I guess it's Orianna's the most fed at this point. Ooh, double spinning axes. This very well could be another tower going down for release. Spiders are getting attacked first, which is really, really nice. Bam, that is going to be two towers going down. And oh, that's... I feel really bad for the red team. It's 18 kills to 3, 5 towers to 0. It's not safe. It's not a safe position for the red team to be in. It's going to be very difficult for them to come back from this. They're already down by 13,000 gold at 15 minutes, which... I think is one of the biggest like deficits I've seen at this early in the game. That's a ridiculous amount at 15 minutes. Yeah, that's definitely not good. Ooh, distance almost reaches Elise, and they could very well just completely take this on. No, Elise is gonna get flung back over. Is she gonna be able to do anything? No, she won't. She gets shut down finally. That is gonna be a finally killed Elise. Very unfortunate, giving out the killing spree, but that is gonna help the red team significantly. Although she's gonna be able to go back and buy some items now, which is not gonna be safe for them at all. We're gonna get to Liandry's Torment. It has the Seeker's Arm Guard, and it's just, it's not looking good. The red team pretty much has nothing. Oh, instead of taking a ton of damage, almost dying to Lulu there. That would have been really embarrassing, but unfortunately, she does not do that much damage. It would have been cool if she was like carry Lulu, but being 006 and kind of going all support items as she should be. It's pretty understandable why she wasn't able to do that kind of damage. I really like Liandry's Torment on Orianna because every time she just smacks somebody with her ball, it just can go through everybody and it just puts on that debuff. It's really, really nice. Oh, we have a nice bit of engage. Once again, completely obliterating this Rumble. Rumble's down by almost 50 CS at this point. Wow, huge engage going down to bottom. Orianna's in a tough position, but the cocoon missing. Oh, is she going to go down with it? Yes, she does. The repel now going down. And ooh, the box now landing with the exhaust. That is going to be ridiculously bad for Elise, but she's going to be able to do enough damage. Descent's now coming out. Is she going to get anything else? No, the lantern will save them. That is going to be the first inhibitor tower of the game. And wow, Nidalee is also going to be pushing another inhibitor tower. They're not able to take the inhibitor. Elise doing a ridiculous amount of damage. Is she going to be able to get this kill? Nice repel and bam. Easily pick up, but boom. That is a really bad situation. Gets completely ripped to shreds. And Nidalee is going to run out of here as fast as possible. Oh, that's not good. She should have sped up herself. That's scary. Oh, just barely picking it up. Even with the shield from the lantern and the grab axe, still took the damage that they needed. And the pink ward is going to help out just a little bit. Zed trying to get in there to throw down his ultimate, but just wasn't even close to enough. Raven's now in the mix. That could be really bad. Gets a nice stand aside, and holy crap, those chunks! Will the bleep kill him? No, not quite, but the last auto attack will, and that is going to be a nice cleanse for him. Shield from Orianna could be very, very useful in this particular situation. But Draven being so low, not really having too much. Wow, the Whirling Death being able to pick up the kill on the way back. Beautiful job. And Leandre's Torment keeping that dot down, but he is able to pick up. Draven also picking up that kill. Barrier coming out, but the auto attacks from Draven are just way too strong. Triple kill now coming down for Draven. And that is an ace for the red team. Nidalee coming in. Who is she going to heal? Nobody. Herself. Scumbag. Oh no, this is not good. Oh my god, is he gonna pick it up? 20 HP, dead, wow. He almost had no health and he was able to pick that up. That's how scary Draven is when he has two of those spinning axes. Try to survive with the Bloodthirster and the lifesteal from that just wasn't quite enough. Red team's turret has been destroyed. Nidalee doing what she can. Elise, oh, in a bad situation. She's going to go hard in the paint. Is she going to get healed, though? That is the question. She's going to repel all the way to the minions in the back and try to get away through the back. Throws on the repel and goes right onto Rumble. Bam, able to pick up the kill. The flay goes down and the fling on top of that. Death Sentence now on Nidalee. She's going to have to get away, but she's just going to pounce out of there pretty easily. Man, those auto attacks are just, they're getting a little bit hurty after she throws out a spell just because of that sheen. Oh, nice hit on that spear. Not quite as much as her flat out AP Nidalee would do, of course, since she only has 40 AP, but still a pretty nice chunk. And she may just go directly for this blue buff. Not quite landing the jump. There you go. And probably giving this to Orianna. No, it actually goes on to Draven. Unfortunately, I mean, it's okay with Draven. He gets faster Whirling Death, stand aside, Blood Rush. But his cooldowns are still so high, you're still only going to be able to get one, maybe two in a fight. The Spinning Axe, you'll get an additional one if you need to drop one, that type of thing, but that's about it. Wow, I'm surprised this game is still going on. This is still only 26,000 gold at the 21 minute mark. They're so far behind right now. Red team is not having a good time, but they're trying to come back. They're still staying in it. They're picking up kills where they can. They're trying to hold off the minions, but they're just not doing that much damage to them. And this looks like it very well could be the first inhibitor, but still no Elise going in. Gets flung out, throws on the repel, goes directly on. Ooh, chunking him down for about half his HP. Those auto attacks are doing so much. Nidalee doing a great job. He's gonna try to flip out of there. Gets flung back and then play. Bam, gets completely obliterated. Orianna pulls in three members of the red team with that ultimate. And the lantern goes down just to keep him alive from Leandre's Torment's burn. And oh my gosh, she goes in real hard. Whirling Death picking up a three kills. And wow, quadra kill coming out. Wow, that was beautiful job by Draven, picking up a quadra kill. Quantic did a great job this game, you cannot deny that. Completely shut out the opposing team. And there was just, yeah, there was nothing they could do about that. That is going to be GG. Wow. So congratulations to Quantic for winning that particular matchup. Yeah, that was just a really great, great play overall. So congratulations to the blue team. GG to the red team. Again, if you guys like the videos, make sure to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button if you want to see more, because I try to come out with videos about every day. And if you subscribe, you will be notified whenever there is an upload, as well as you're much more likely to get whatever request you request fulfilled as soon as possible. So if you have any requests for champions or players that you want to see, you know, always submit that request either through the comment section or a private message, and I will get back to you and let you know. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. I will see you later. Peace.